Hello and welcome to the LOL RVA Try Hard Pre-Made Fives Tourney. I have myself, Mr. Brian Savage X2, co-casting with
Jasper Incarnation. And they're running into the jungle. Getting starting positions up. I thought we had. Okay.
That's what I thought.
Yeah, we're fine.
Alright, well, having a couple technical difficulties, but we're gonna go ahead and get the stream started up shortly. For today's match, we have Washed Up versus Team NICE Nice.
And looks like they're playing some of their signature champions. Zara has been stolen away from Sharpie, and Might is on his signature Cinder, who is one of his only mid lane picks as an ADC main.
If anybody knows about the purple Sharpie and her Zyra, can't even call it a one trick when they don't play anything else. No trick, that's it. That's all they have.
Jace, pretty meta pick, been played a lot at Worlds. Olaf also played a lot of Worlds. It's basically a pretty meta pick for red side, except for Soraka, and then blue side is more of a comfort pick personal champions, I would say, except for the bot lane. Ezreal's played a lot, Zarya's played a lot, but the other champions are kind of niche, especially York has been released professionally, so we don't know how good he is or not. Alright.
I think this will be interesting, seeing Alamander playing AD carry, considering he's typically a solo lane main.
Flashing masteries on blue side.
Looking at the team comps, it looks like we got pretty much a kind of a poke comp here from Team Nice. Syndra gets patches, nice little poke from the Jace, and the Olaf to just run around and do as he Ragnarok up.
Yeah.
Even though
I wouldn't exactly classify Syndra as a poke champion. I think they have about even poke because they've got
level one, we've got Zeraf a little action down Ezreal here in the river.
They're just trading. There's nothing to fight over.
Like everybody's backing off, maybe. So, not a much going on so far. Kind of ran down to get an early scout and met each other in the river and then backed off. Like, we're going to have very matching starts from the junglers, both starting on the bottom side. So, looking like they're going to meet at the top lane first gank. Have anything? Do you think we'll have a early gank or are we going to get a full clear?
Olaf probably is going to have a full clear and Hecarim too. These are both champions that don't do well in early ganks, really, because there's no hard CC from either of them. So these are champions that want to farm up, get at least level 4 before they start ganking. But you never know.
So both bot lanes, the junglers. Really interested to see this top lane matchup because, like I said, there haven't really been any competitive Yorks played.
Yeah, well, he's not up on the patch. He's not up on 618, so it's impossible.
I happen to think that Olaf is actually a pretty strong champion. Oh, not Olaf, but York.
Yeah, I feel like Jace definitely wins this matchup. If Jace plays it right, he should just poke out the York. And get a
Jace
CS
going
lead
into Hammer form. Got a little Mystic Shot poke going down onto purple Sharpie, yeah, by the Ezreal.
Only there's actually a large CS difference opening up in bot lane because they're zoning them off all the CS. They're going to miss most of the wave because it's going to crash onto the tower. So Lucian's going to have to do a really good job at farming under tower. And right now he's 6 CS behind already.
That's some ward action, and yeah, the Ezreal and Zyra just putting down way too much poke.
Yeah, Zyra's actually an incredibly annoying champion early. because she doesn't rely on her mana to spawn some of her plants, and the poke damage is actually kind of insane.
Got the first gank in the top lane by Smashims.
Oh, yeah.
Alright,
it's
finally
almost
get the
successful. Looks like Hecum's gonna go, but he gets knocked off, and they're just gonna back off, I guess.
I think that was an actually terrible gank by the Hecarim, because he had less health than the Olaf even did, so if they really wanted to, they could have just, like, turned on him.
There's not, there's not really a whole lot Hecarim can do at level 3, especially when he's at this low health. But that's Ghost burned from Hecarim and Flash burned from Yorick, so... And that's only for the Ghost on...
I'd like to take note of the Summoner spells that we've got, Ghost taken by both junglers and also both mid laners, as opposed to the teleports or ignite. Yeah.
Well, these are very you don't usually take ignite on either of these mid laners, and you wouldn't take teleport. These are champions that don't use teleport really well. And Ghost is just so powerful because it has such a short cooldown, and it's so good for the immobile mid laners that are meta right now. Olaf is going back up for
we got Olaf coming back caught, and he gets hit by the
circle,
gate
but he looks
again,
like he's dead.
But this time Pixelbot doesn't have
Flash. And nope, still.
Alright, first blood goes to Olaf.
Which is good, because we just saw Peanut go 11-0 in their game.
Oh yes, Alamander's getting engaged on 2v1. Where's his support? Zyra's roamed into the river and left her support all alone. Quick poke down. One thing you kind of have to be wary of, I know that you're Ezreal and you're super mobile with your Arcane Shift, but you still can't 2v1, especially not at level 4. Got a miss Q from the purple Sharpie.
Soraka's almost out of mana, so he's not going to be extremely
useful. Alright, so we got a lot of poke going down in the mid lane.
He only has enough mana for about two skills. Yeah, a good Xerath will poke out Syndra fairly early, because Syndra does run out of mana before she gets her last chapter, and Xerath's passive keeps his mana pool up.
We got whole lot of mana being spent down bottom by the Soraka, by the purple Sharpie. She's like practically oomed.
Yeah, she has enough for about 1 to 2 more skills, but they're going to look to go back soon, because Lucian has enough gold for BF if he's going to go the crit build, or if he's going to go the armor pen build, he has enough for that too.
Lucian also picking up a little bit of extra gold off these plants.
Yeah, 5 extra gold, so you have to keep that in mind with the CS count.
Taking note of the New York, something that I like about him is that his E, I can't remember the skill name, but it does percent health damage. So, a few of those over time is just actually going to add up and hurt.
Looks like Xerath is going to roam down bot. He's looking to maybe yank, but that lane is pretty far pushed up, so that there's not really anything he can make happen there.
Definitely can't dive.
He can do some poke. Oh, and Flash out comes
looks
out,
like
and
we're
the rest of them are dodged, so she'll stay safe.
Alright, so we got...
4-man collapse coming down from Syndra.
Syndra with the counter.
He's exhausted. And I don't think there's going to be anything happening here. Flash.
Oh, we got a flash from Syndra.
But it ends up just being nothing. So that's actually a pretty significant waste. Flash and ult burned. And now she won't have that. But it looks like they rotated.
And the Jace is really going hard on the York, can't kite him. Kiting around, maybe? And Hecarim saves the day. Man, talk about being way to be at the right place at the right time. But because Hecarim showed top, now we're going to have a dragon by the red team.
And that's definitely worth, because it's Infernal. It's an Infernal Drake. And
it
now
they're
going to go
try
off the blue
trade
buff.
The first turret for that. It's going down kind of fast.
I don't think they're going to get it, because the TP's coming out from Jace, yeah. And they're out of minions, so...
Oh, so he's going kind of ham, but he's
taking
a whole lot of
damage. He's taking a lot of turret damage,
Don't know if they can dive him, though.
Yeah, they definitely can't.
Oh, I think Jace might be able to turn this around with a nice EQ combo.
Looks like he's not going for it though. He just wants to clear out the minion wave, so they will have trouble diving him. Oh, he's posturing very aggressively. Yeah, and Xerath is coming up to maybe snipe him. I think he's probably going to get him. He's burned the ghost, but he's missed everything except for the Aesir Fort. And here comes Olaf for the counter gank.
Oh, he might.
And Hecarim's back.
Still there, but he doesn't really have any mana. Or hell.
Hecarim is coming in and
just gonna chase him down with the Undertow chain.
Realm from Syndra picks up the double, so that's a 2-0. Just really good follow up by the rest of the team.
Ezreal ult coming back, maybe. Oh, it looks like they alerted and then he pinged him out of the way. Alright. But yes, really good synergy by Team Nice. Way to communicate that, hey, this guy's up here diving me, and the team follows up.
Yeah, I mean, you have to look at the mechanical plays there, because Xerath missed two skill shots, which if he had hit them instead, he would have gotten the kill. But it delayed them so much trying to get that kill that it gave Nice time to collapse. And you just can't do that.
Also, that was also really good for the Jace. He ended up collecting assists off for that, which is going to help him get back, considering he's down about 16 DPS. So
yeah,
that assist really, really helped give him a little
extra gold. Which is surprising in a ranged melee matchup, but... But yeah, Olaf is off to a great start. 2-0. He's up 6 CS over his opponent, which is not a great, which is not a huge CS lead, but it is.
Yeah, two kills to go along with it.
Yeah.
So, seems like with the Hecarim jungle here, I feel like his job should be to pressure earlier, because he has a lot more gank potential early on than the Olaf does, but it's just Olaf's just beating him to the punch, man. You know, he had a much faster jungle clear, much better rotations. He's getting around the map more. I don't even want to say more CC, but he's.
Oh, it looks like he's going damage. For another gank on Jace. He's blowing the Ian, but yes, he's getting heavily traded on by the Jace.
Doing a lot of damage. And here comes Hulk Smash.
He's caught
with the Ragnarok. You know, it's going to get caught in the gate.
Looks like Yorick might be dead though, because he's pretty surrounded. Oh wow, there comes Onslaught of Shadows.
Oh, what a
turnaround. Take him down.
Yeah, see, that's where that percent health damage just comes into play.
Now Syndra's here though, what can she do?
Oh, and then bottom.
Unleashes the power.
Alright, so down bottom we've got the Culling.
But here, Yorick's on a killing spree. 4-0, and he's going to take that first tower of the game, get that 400 extra gold for his team.
And just a recap of what happened. Bottom, there was pretty much a nice engage. Lucian got off a nice culling, even through the Stranglethorns by Zara, and managed to kill her. That's one of the pains of being one of the squishy champions in the game. Like 2v1, engaging the Alamander, with 9th Ambition coming in, but they still managed to take down the Lucian, and the Zara has the flash, or else she's going to die, but she still dies anyway to the Xerathal. Soraka? Was a Soraka that has to play.
Yeah.
My apologies. So, we got Hulk Smashems hanging around by the mid lane. Looks like he sneaks undetected into the red jungle, where Hecarim is down clearing some Krugs.
They've got really good ward coverage in that bottom side jungle, though.
Definitely. Oh, yes, because there's three pings all around the red side. Oh, wait. Got a little action here. Has the flash. Oh, and the clutch stun by Xerath. This Yorick is putting down ridiculous amounts of damage right now. The percent health damage on top of the Sheen procs from the Q doing bonus damage is just like shredding through Jace. Even though he can burst, even though Jace has burst, Yorick has just as much as well as sustained damage from his
He does now that he's 30 CS ahead and has 4 kills, so Jace can't trade with him anymore.
Yeah, it's just
Looks like they're going for Rift Herald now.
Hecarim is using his pressure really good to help snowball the lead top. He keeps ganking top over and over again. Seems like all the action is really top focused from both junglers. So they have this good shock blast, but he can't steal the Rift Herald. Oh, what a calling by Lucian. What a... So, right here, Rift Herald went down, Zyra blows her ult, but pretty much that Rift Scuttler ended up giving it away that they were trying to two-man the Rift Herald, and Red Team recognized that and just collapsed. So, just a failed sneak.
Infernal though. They can't fight it, they're not there. Exactly. Hecarim's just been in base, that's gonna be second Infernal.
When getting greedy goes wrong. Oh.
Ezreal's going in there, he's picked
so
up.
They secure it. Chase. Alamander comes in. Arcane Shift over the wall to get the hype on the Weeb King, who got very low from all that poke from the dragon. Can he hit the stun? Can we get a stun from Xerath? No, we got a dash. And looks like,
oh, looks like Hecarim Onslaught of Shadows goes in and they pick up Lucian.
Onslaught of Shadows to get in range. And rotating over to the bot side, we got a flash from the ninth. Stops him back, so now they're taking the bot tower.
And Xerath had ult, he could kill either one of them, but he doesn't have it, so... They're just gonna go push up for that second tier bot turret, waiting for the minion wave. It's clearing out bot side jungle, so there's not a whole lot of gold. Ball off to get. And he's gone boot to Swift Diffs, and he hasn't completed his jungle item yet.
Well, at 2-1-4, like, you don't really need as much of a jungle item. He just go for combat stats.
Yeah, he's just trying to survive the magic damage from Xerath. And no, he's got the boots of Swift Diffs to get to reduce the slows, but I don't think it's going to be enough.
It pretty much looks like we had a mirror of what happened in the top lane. Blue team decided they wanted to do an objective. Red team collapses on it. Then afterwards, red team goes for their objective, and blue team collapses, and they end up taking it. And except their victory ended up being, oh man, so much Yorick damage. Hulk Smash and said Ragnarok active. He's still taking so much damage. They can't even turn it.
Oh, Xerath. Oh, I think Xerath's firing his ult blind, so he doesn't know what's coming. And the Ezreal ult picks up the kill on Sinta.
Oh my goodness. True Shot Barrage brings down
Flash,
the Knight after
and then
dodging
the Zyra ult looks to keep him safe, but I think she might have sacrificed herself for her to... Yep, there. McAvage picks it up.
So we had so many ults burnt. Zyra thought she could solo the Soraka and the Lucian, but between the heal... Right. And in an exhaust, she just can't live. But she does help keep the killing spree intact for Alamander on Ezreal.
She does, which is good because there would be Shutdown Gold if it had been him that had died.
Note
but
that
then
we had a random flash from Might on Syndra, which ended up costing him because he tried to flash a Xerath ulti, or actually flash right before the Xerath ulti.
Alamander's in trouble though. I think he's going down. Yeah, there he goes.
Yeah, there's no
basically
escaping
soloed by the Jace.
No escaping the Jace when you're low on mana.
He had Flash. I guess he was probably trying to get over the Dragon Ball, but I guess he had used his E in a manner that didn't save him somehow. And Ragnarok comes out. He's but
Ragnarok
he just doesn't want to dive
again.
The tower.
He's going hard, but he can't dive him under tower.
Even though they did win that teamfight, though, they're still down 3.5k, basically. Which is going to be a hard thing to fight against with their comp, because they're all short range except for Jace.
I really like what Hulk Smashem is doing. He's putting a lot of pressure on the map, so even though it got his team the early lead, and even though their lead is dwindling now, he's still trying to keep up the pressure. But the thing is, they invested so much in the top lane that he's a monster now. He's got a fully completed Trinity Force, he's got Merc Treads, a Giant's Belt, and Cloth Armor. Composed to the Ghost Blade and not even completed boots from the Jace.
Yeah, Jace only sitting on that Yuma's Ghost Blade and a couple minor things. He has a Fairy Charm, which I'm not sure what he's building into. I guess he thinks he really needs that mana. And you see four of their members have the Farsight token, so you can see that they're really afraid to go into the Fog of War.
They wanna have... Oh, so many ghouls, man. That
York got the kill on Jace solo again, so Jace sitting on 6 deaths out of 11 for his entire team. He must be feeling a little bit oppressed right now by this Zoroark.
Zoroark is really strong, man. The ghoul damage on top of the machine auto Q, really strong. I think Zoroark's actually a really strong champion. I'm not sure why he hasn't been played in competitive play across any region at all.
Well, he's not enabled on the patch, so.
Oh, gotcha.
But yeah, I mean, this is going to happen when your Zoroark is up 3,000 gold up on Jace. Jace is only sitting on 5,500, and Yorick's on 8,500, so. That's going to happen. Even though Yorick is pushed up really far, the team isn't collapsing because they're trying to defend their mid tower, so.
Alright, so let's see what Hulk Smash can do, even though he's 3 levels down, apparently. Tons of damage.
Hulk Smash him is 3 levels down on who?
On Yorick.
Yes. But he's even with his opponent jungler, but.
Oh, yes.
Yeah. Pixel Bob is just so far ahead of Jace. Every conceivable advantage has gone his way.
So, looking at the mid lane matchup, Syndra isn't doing terrible. 2-2-3, 120 CS.
No, she's doing okay.
CS is even. Down a kill and an assist. Bot lane seems to be going well. Even though he's down a good 20 CS, he's still, you know, up in kills.
He is, and he looks like he's going for a Black Cleaver next, which is pretty standard Yoma's Black Cleaver build. Lucian has a good mid-game, early-game power spike, which they're hitting, but they're still down 4k as a team. Ezreal's, even though he hasn't completed any item, he hasn't completed his 25th.
Another
force.
Inferno Drake is up, and actually, Nice seems to get there first. They've established.
Oh, wow, and that's a steal.
And the True Shot Barrage steal. Job,
that's
Alexander.
Something you don't see very much. I mean, you gotta put that on Miss Smite.
That's really good. Miss Smite from Hulk Smash. It's just when we were talking about how good he was doing. Of course, Yorick doesn't care. He just pushed. So, what can Jace do to get back in this matchup and just stop getting erased by the Yorick?
He's 70 CS down. There's not really a whole lot he can do at the moment. You have to, and he's a mid-game power spike champion, so the fact that he's down at this point is not spelling good things. I mean, as a team, if they get a good pick, they have a reasonable amount of CC from the Syndra, but that's really all they have. Soraka's right. Not going to snare anyone, because that just doesn't happen unless you aren't paying attention. Lucian doesn't have any CC, of course, because
the lack of hard CC is probably what's hurting this team. Ninth Ambition just can't do anything to when Olaf presses R, man. He just runs at you and
And then Olaf is hitting. It looks like they're just going to rotate down for Baron. It's a really early Baron, and Lucian's out of mana. So I think this is a very good idea.
Yeah, this is really risky, because then it becomes a 50-50, and your team doesn't have any.
And there goes the Syndra. She's dead.
Oh, Alamander claiming
Lucian
a blue
trying
buff.
To solo the Ezreal, but it's not happening. Ezreal has on a killing spree now.
Yeah, so this just really turned out bad, because it became a 50-50 smite when the strongest member on both teams is right up in the top lane, and while you're trying to sneak the bear in.
Yeah, that's just a really bad call in general. Plus, I guess they thought they wouldn't know, but. Blueside had a ward.
Might sticking around
bush.
And being so low and end up being just a free blue buff transfer to the Ezreal.
And I don't think this game is going to be very much longer, because we're looking at a huge gold lead, 8k Baron buff.
Looking at the scores, we've got 5-3-2 on Yorick and 5-1-1 on Ezreal. That's really strong.
Yeah.
He's decided to go the Trinity Force build. He's got two items with Trinity Force and a Man Immune.
Yeah, he's a little bit behind on the Mermana upgrade. He's still got 200 to go for it, but he'll get it soon.
Wondering why there's still a call in his inventory? Is there any stacks left on it?
No, he's maxed out on that one, so I guess he just hasn't sold it yet. It looks like he's going for a Bloodthirster next, even though he could have just built the Vamp Scepter, but.
My money, he goes for Blade of the Rune King next. But it could be Bloodthirster.
Oh, right, the book. It is it is probably broken. Well, even though I'm not sure the game is going to last long enough for him to buy that.
I do know that the Blade of the Rune King build is typically built when you play with the Iceborne Gauntlet.
Yeah. It's fairly typical for all the way, actually. It just gives you more poking power, and since Ezreal isn't really a big crit champion, what helps you the most.
Alright, so Might really getting poked down here. He just...
Yeah, and it looks like the Zerathold is coming out, but it's not really hitting a whole lot. Yeah, I think he just missed all shots. Zerath
and True Shot Barrage from Ezreal. Doesn't really hit much. There goes
Might, just sniped out by the Ezreal Zerath combination. Not him there, the mastery emote. They're just trying to poke them off the turret. Use that Baron buff to take the tower.
The range is just too long. Soraka can only do so much. Alright, so we got a Flash, Grasping Roots, and a Stranglethorns. All of it misses. Soraka still goes down.
Big Ragnarok coming out. Almost takes out Ambition.
Culling almost nearly 100 to 0's 9th Ambition, but he stays alive. And he's still a threat because he stands so far in the back.
Oh, there he goes.
Double kill by the Hecarim.
I mean, and that's worth though, because now they have a free timer on that inhibitor turret, and the inhibitor might go down. Meanwhile, Top is pushing. He's trying to get another solo kill. He might get it in time before he goes to the front, but he's not going to get it.
Yeah, so what really killed them is the fact that their lack of hard CC, because outside of Syndra, they have no hard CC at all, and they're just locking everybody up, even if it's only between a Grasping Root or the wall from York or the Zera stun. They just hold them in place, and then they have good target focus.
And we're seeing the Zerathalt come again. He looks like if he fires it right, he might get a double, but no, he misses the last shot. And Lucian goes in. He does get off the Zerathalt, but he's going to go flash, down.
Pick up a little bit of gold, but once again, kill. The CC and just holds him in place, and he just can't escape. So what I'd really like to see out of Team Nice next time is more CC. They were just so reliant on the stuns from the Syndra. But what happens when you have somebody who can stun from further and just poke from way further than you can? They're just getting outranged.
They're getting outranged, and the people usually pick York into a combination that has Karma or Sivir for a speed up, but the Soraka is not enabling him because he has to run at people, and if he can't catch them, there's not a whole lot he can do.
I also agree with that. It's like he fits in the poke comps if you know have somebody can speed him up, but because that seems to be the typical. You have either a Karma or a Zillion or a Sivir or somebody who could just make him go fast, but they just don't have none of that. So maybe he was a drafting error. Well, it's definitely a drafting error, but.
It's a drafting error, but it's also a teamwork error because we saw the top play went badly.
Free ocean,
not just because of the champions, but it went badly because of play. Because they just ended up getting caught in bad positions by a collapsing team. And now they're 15k behind, and it's really over.
It's really hard when you can't get to the Xerath and he has just so much free poke damage.
Yeah,
my god, Zyrix is deleted.
I do not like playing against Xerath. I almost never win lane. And he has so much AoE damage. He's really good at team fighting too. You have to really pick on him in lane and get him really far behind. Or pick on him in the team fights and just focus him out. But that's hard to do.
But it's really hard because they have so many people standing in front of him between the Yorick and the Zyra. Even the Zyra and the
Zyra has good disengage.
Oh, a great disengage.
Yeah. And Olaf just basically can't catch up because you see he has the Rylai's, and even though Olaf has the Spear Visage and he has the Mercury Treads, he's still getting slowed by the 40% slow. And Xerath is just so strong right now. They're just running through
the
everything.
The Ezreal poke is so real, like, hit really hard.
He has 3 items, more mana at 27 minutes. This is his best. This is your dream point. For Ezreal.
And Alamander still has not sold his call. I guess that extra 5-7 on hit is really coming in handy.
Yeah, well, I guess he's just... I think they're hitting the Nexus turret. It's pretty over.
Like, it's going to be GG. Game 1 goes to... Washed Up. Jace got a last whisper, but it was all too late.
I was trying to get it.
So, what I'd like to see more is they've got the Immortals syndrome where they just don't draft a whole lot of CC.
Yeah, I mean that's a minor. It's not a minor issue, but it's understandable when people aren't used to drafting as five. They're kind of probably just choosing comfort champions, and at some point you just need to think of how it's going to work when you're fighting as a team and not fighting as a solo queue. And we're going to take about a 60-second minute break now, and we'll be back with the second game.
Alright guys, welcome back to game 2 of the LOL RBA Tryhard Premade 5s tournament. Nice and ICE versus Washed Up. I think we're gonna have Nice on blue side and Washed Up on red this time.
Yeah, well hopefully we'll have a little bit of a closer game this time, because even though they had a fairly even early game, it just went really downhill really fast, and we got a sub 30 minute win.
I really like the Olaf pressure, which is a little bit uncharacteristic for Olaf because he doesn't have early on, but decided that, you know, top lane was focus. That seemed to be the focus of the game, because all ganks were going early on, but eventually the pressure just got to the Jace, and he just the amount of ghouls and everything just coming at you is so hard to deal with, considering you're pretty much single target. So I can only hit one person at a time while I've got all these ghouls and all these minions and a champion. And if I'm level 6, then I've got the maiden attacking also. So that just in order for success this game, I think Nice needs more CC and more CC, honest, because they couldn't hold anybody in place outside of a Zyra stun. I'm sorry, Syndra stun. Meanwhile, they're just getting poked down from a million miles away by a super fed Xerath.
Yeah, and Jace is really a pick that you go to win lane with. It's an awkward champion outside of lane sometimes, and if you don't win lane and you're that far behind, it's really hard to come back because you're immobile. You're not very durable. You can't really build tank on him. You can build tank E a little bit. You're kind of Bruiser-esque, but it's hard to come back on that champion if you're behind. And we saw some people doing well, but basically laning didn't go very well for the entire team. Everyone was down CS, and it kind of snowballed into the team fights where they started out with a 3k gold lead at about 10 to 12 minutes, and it just went up from there, and they never really got off the ground. They had some good dragon pickups, which made up for some of the deficit, but it wasn't enough to make up for the whole thing. And it looks like both team comps are drastically different. We've got the Ezreal from McAverage again. You've got the Ezreal who's been stolen away from Alamander, one presumes, and you've got an entirely different champ to look for both teams. Except for the Ezreal, all 10 champions are different. We've got Zac, Hulk Smashins, signature jungle play. And
coming into this, we've got an Alawi pick from the Weeb King. Not really sure how I feel against the Trundle. This Trundle's going to be able to steal a whole lot of stats. Just looking at what the team comps like to do, we've got good control of the lane from the Cassiopeia by Might, some good poke from Nami, Ezreal. But then on the other side from Washed Up, we've got like an Anivia, a Twitch, a Trundle, which seem they want to control kind of the terrain that they fight in. Going right here, got a little purple shot caught out.
I don't think that Cassiopeia actually wins this lane. I think Anivia has a longer range, and she has just better zone control, and I think she's probably going to be able to play this lane.
First blood goes over to Janna. That should be interesting. In a lot of fight, Twitch putting on a lot of damage, but he's trying to kite back. The Crimson Cookie is just kind of waiting to assassinate somebody. Looks like it's going to be Ezreal. Or, we get a flash. Oh, but Anivia's still coming. Maybe an auto. And the Ninth Ambition picks it up with the Knight. So already we've got a 2-0 lead for Washed Up. Considering Twitch is a very weak champion, especially in the laning phase, really good for him to pick up an assist, especially to have first blood on Fort Janna, so that gets you extra gold early on to start building AP, to really buff up those shields.
Yeah. And I mean, it's not exactly optimal. You'd probably rather have that first blood on literally anyone else, but it doesn't hurt. It's better than giving it. And every single person was in that. So you see, everyone has either an assist or a kill, which is really good for them.
And we've even got two on Trundle.
Yeah, and Trundle actually went out and bought a Vision Ward, and that's really smart because now he's gonna have a good awareness of where
permanent vision
damage is coming from. Yeah. Because even though Zac has a really good ganker from out of vision, so we'll have to see that. And Twitch can have a difficult lane, but he's got Janna to buff him up, and that's actually one of Crimson Rage's most. I think that is his most played support, and he's a diamond support. He's been master tier before, so I think they're probably going to have a pretty safe lane.
All right, so we got the level 2 from Washed Up, and they seem to be going pretty hard on the purple Sharpie, and the almost takes it with the Contaminate, gets super low.
Yeah, and that's some of the early power. You can see, I mean, because the shield gives extra AD, so even though you wouldn't think they're a very powerful duo, there are some. And you can see top, Weeb King has had to burn Flash just to survive, and he's been completely forced out of lane.
Speaking of summoner spells, what I'd like to look out is the fact that, one, Pixel Bob took Exhaust, therefore he doesn't have a TP. So now the Weeb King goes right back to lane and dies again? Alright, I definitely didn't see that one coming.
Well, he's a level down, and Trundle is just so strong. Yeah, he just... He thought he could take it, but the level difference and the
army of minions, man. That's something also to take note of.
Yeah, you don't
look at
fight
that huge,
when you're
that's
down.
At least like 15 minions.
Yeah, he really underestimated that, and that's a huge CS lead. It's basically just like the last game. It's going to be a really hard time for him up top lane.
Yeah, I really questioned the Alawi pick because, and she doesn't really offer kind of much D, and she's supposed to be this. Oh man, we got a Hulk Smash. Some's flying in with the elastic slingshot for the nice little gank, man.
And you see Purple Sharpie actually set up that really nicely with her Water Prison, Aqua Prison, so he couldn't get out of it, even if he had Flash, which he didn't.
Really much nothing. There wasn't much Janna could do about that one.
Not
but
really. Without her
but,
ult, Janna doesn't have...
All right, we got a gank in the mid lane. Might's gonna...
Survivability.
Gonna jump over the Miasma and get walled, get stunned, but doesn't have enough damage. It definitely pushes Might out of lane. But, I was saying about the summoner spell. So Weeb King has a TP to Pixel Bob's exhaust. So Pixel Bob is just looking to once again continue off what he did in the previous game and just dominate the laning phase and just translate that lead into the rest of the game.
And it's also good against Cassiopeia because you really drastically lower her DPS. And since she's a very mobile champion, if you lower that,
Ninth Ambition has Ignite again and is able to trade kills. Not even trade kills. Jan no, he comes out ahead because of the egg.
And Zac just doesn't do very much damage. He has a lot of CC, but if the damage dies, that's really it.
All right, so we got a little trade. Test the Spirit lands. Able to kill the clone. And we got two tentacles, but he's still just sustaining through it. He's a monster.
He's actually dodging a lot of the... He's dodging a lot of the damage. He's just going to back off now because he flashes in. Oh, and there's the kill. Yeah, 2-0-2. Yeah, and this is just going to snowball from here. I don't see Illaoi ever really becoming a threat in this game because she has to get off the ground in her lane because she's really an annoying champion to play against, but if she gets behind, it's hard for her to come back because she's really short ranged. I wish I would
have been able to see the pick ban, the draft phase, to see where this Trundle was drafted in comparison to the Illaoi, because Trundle just seems like a super hard counter pick, you know? Illaoi's thing is getting real beefy and sustaining off the tentacles, but then you just got Trundle who just like, no, now your defensive stats are mine.
Yeah, and Trundle's a really powerful pick because of that
action ultimate. Going on everywhere. All right, so... And Contaminate can't get it down, but we got a flash from the Crimson Cookie. Exhaust goes down. We got a heal. Flash, all summoners down appears bot. No, but we still got a flash on Twitch and we still got everything on Janna. So the Crimson. Oh,
a lot happening bot. The auto. A lot not happening. Much in the end.
So we've got ults galore.
It's not in the end though. He flashes and he still gets hit by the auto and that heavy damage. He dodges the ice out and Kha'Zix comes in for it.
So we had Alamander almost pick up the kill on the purple Sharpie, but the sustain comes through, can't get it with the Contaminate. Then the Exhaust saves from the Flash from the Kha'Zix. Ezreal comes in and picks up a kill, even after a Flash, because you can't run away from auto attacks. Big party bot.
Meanwhile, Illaoi's come bot, but she's missing another wave. She has teleport, but she's still just getting farther and farther behind this Chandra who's
there goes
sitting...
the TP coming out now.
Yep. But she's still going to miss most of the minions in that wave probably because it's going to crash in the tower. She'll probably pick up a couple.
Look at the gold differential she missed... here.
She got most of them actually, so that's good for her.
Look at the gold differential so far.
He's still down 1.2k.
Yeah, we've got 3,100 from Trundle compared to the 2,000 to Illaoi. That seems to be like the biggest discrepancy. Oh, the ult comes down and it's doing a lot of damage to the Trundle, to the clone, but he runs away.
Yeah, he put the pillar down to ignite him.
But the thing is, Trundle still has
subjugate. He reduced the damage coming out.
Yeah, and Trundle still has subjugate, and with his passive, he can just heal right back up.
Yeah.
Oh, we got a gold coming in mid. And once again, the Ninth Ambition has Ignite again. But this time he doesn't make it because there's no Agnivia.
Yeah, but he does. He actually flashed in to get the Ignite, so he really wanted that trade. He
once again, up top.
Probably dead.
Oh, and once again up top. Yeah, just because Trundle held on to all his spells, he just was able to use Subjugate and just sustain back up. Got a gank going down mid. Looks like Kha'Zix versus Zac, but Kha'Zix can't kill the Zac under the Bloblets.
That is a valuable pickup though, because he doesn't burn anything to get that out. So next time Zac dies, he actually does die. And we're actually seeing Trundle freeze the wave up top to try to keep it in a good position for himself. But he's really valuable though, because he's just doing really well on his own. He's not taking pressure, so Kha'Zix is free to gank the other lanes, but he's just doing really well on his own, and that's really valuable for his team.
Yeah, it's looking, it's really good because since Top is essentially just going so free, I'm not even sure if Kha'Zix has been up there once. That just means that the Crimson Cookie is just free to go to every other lane.
Yeah.
And Hulk Smash him seems to be, oh my god, the combo from Anivia, just Purple Sharpie taking so much damage. She just seems to catch every skill shot.
Well,
But
she's zoned off by the wall, so there's really nowhere else she could go. Well,
oh,
this
we
is
got
my
a
use of the
dragon, potential
wall.
dragon steal picked up by Hulk Smashers. The nice steal.
Yeah.
We
And
also
that's
got a kill
good.
on the Kha'Zix.
I think he
But it
actually
looks
goes
like
in a bit too early, but he gets it anyway.
definitely. All right, Might's gonna go down once again to the ninth ambition, and it's Anivia.
See, oh yeah, Nivea's just huge right now, zoning him off, even with basically auto attacks killing him off. And she's 4-1 and 2. And she hasn't even built any damage yet because she's working on her tier and she's getting her catalyst
Great mana.
for Rod of the Ages. Yeah, she has a lot of mana. And we there's a 20 CS difference in bot lane for Twitch. He's doing fine.
They just constantly shoving. Once again, like I said, because Pixel Bob is just dominating the top lane, Kha'Zix can just ignore that lane and go wherever he want, and they just make plays, so they just show up.
Yeah, even though I think it's actually more on the strength of their laners, because Kha'Zix only has been involved in two of the
Anivia
kills.
ropes down
It's
bottom.
really the Anivia whose roams and CC have really set and damage have really set up for a lot of these
Oh,
kills.
definitely.
She's definitely I
These
other
stuns.
she's definitely MVP right now. Even though Pixel Bob is definitely doing his job as top lane.
But it just seems like with everything that's going on top, Hulk Smashems is spending so much time mid trying to counter this Anivia, but every single time that he ganks, Anivia just has Ignite and just uses it to finish off the Might.
Yeah.
And either he gets saved by a teammate or his
Yeah.
passive,
And
so he just keeps coming out
their
ahead.
team's teamfight damage is really predicated on it is a three threat comp, but
Oh,
right
is that
now
going in
it's really
again?
only a two threat comp because Illaoi is so behind.
Hulk Smashem's able to push Kha'Zix off the Rift Scuttler and secure for himself.
Yeah, Kha'Zix jumps away. Yeah, and the CC is really annoying, especially since Anivia wasn't quite pushed up in the lane. But it's still fine, he doesn't have to flash, he just jumps away, so. And Rift Scuttler on the Rift Herald, it's good vision, it might prevent a gank, but Crimson Cookie hasn't really been up there
All
very
right, nice
much,
Anivia
so.
wall. Elden, nice stun, but Twitch is there. It's like they're just getting stymied. Every time they try to make a play, it's too late, or they're behind, or the other team is just
Well,
already
yeah, I
there.
mean, this really part of it comes from the kind of disaster that they had level one, giving up two kills. They were behind by 1K
Most
pretty
definitely.
soon, and it's
Most
hard to come
definitely.
back from a deficit in League of Legends. You just get farther and farther behind, and it just feels really oppressive to be behind.
Fact that it's about a 5K goal lead at 13 minutes doesn't help at all.
No, not even a little bit.
I would
I mean,
like to
that's.
note that Alawi is, kind of picking up some farms. She's starting to scale. She's getting there, but of course she
Starting.
just doesn't do damage when she's got a longsword, double ruby crystal, and a warden's mail
Yeah.
compared to Trundle, who has a completed Iceborne Gauntlet and a Tiamat.
Yeah. And she's just trying to survive right now. Oh, that was a nice. I just thought you see
All
Janna
right,
just
ults the
canceled.
clone to put a little damage down.
Yeah, but I mean, he's just gonna sustain that back up.
Exactly. So I have a question. How does Nice get back into this game? I would say you got to shut down Anivia, but they've been trying that really, really hard and to no avail. They've been
I
numerous
mean,
sat ganks. He's 0-0-3, but she's still 6-1-3.
yeah, I don't think that's the strategy. I think you have to roam up top and you have to shut down Pixel Bob, and then if you get three, you could go up and get the tower, and you really need to be able to get the Illaoi into
Oh,
the
this
game because
jungle
she's
fight is really
really
bad.
not right now, and she's not going to be very effective. Yeah.
All right, one problem I think that Nice needs to work on is not fighting in the jungle, because that is exactly what they want. Between you can just line up a nice Janna tornado, a nice stun from Anivia, spray and pray by Witch, and then everybody gets cut off between the wall and the pillar by Grundle. So yeah. I just think they need to stay out of the jungle. That's probably a point that they don't want to be in.
Yeah, and...
All right, the poison gets Crimson Cookie, but Ninth Ambition gets, or Twitch, excuse me, Cassiopeia after all.
Yeah, the poison actually gets him in the end, I think.
Oh, we got a potential kill by the Weave Flash. King. Gets Pixelbob down, but he can't finish it, and he has to flash to counter the Ez Flash.
Yeah. But that is showing a good mid-game power spike, but you can see...
Has to heal to cure the poison.
He's actually sitting on 1,000 gold, so... And then, poison. Yeah, we're just seeing a huge... I mean, Top has basically been on an island this whole game. Nothing... The game hasn't snowballed, because he hasn't taken teleport, so he hasn't been able to affect the other lanes. He's just kind of sitting on his lead, hitting a lot of CS. He's actually expanded his CS lead. It's up to about 60 CS now.
Essentially, what he wants to do is, he wants to, like, win his lane super hard and get huge, much larger than everyone is in the rest of the game, save for maybe Anivia, and then just show up and just like, hi guys, what do you do against me? I'm really big.
Yeah, and he's gonna get either Titanic, Hydra, or Ravenous Hydra, and then he's gonna be a really big split-pushing force in a way that Illaoi never really will be, because he's just gonna be able to outmatch her, especially late game. Trundle's early game is actually his weakest point, and the fact that he's ahead right now is just really bad. Because in the end, he'll just steal everyone's stats. It's very interesting he's gone for the Moak treads, though, because there's not really a whole lot of magic damage on...
Yes, he's just kind of thinking, I don't want anything to slow me down. I don't want anything to get in my way. So along with the Merc trade, he picks up a Cloth Armor and a Ruby Crystal, maybe going for...
Yeah. I don't think I would have gone for the boots next. I think I would have finished my Hydra first before I went for a second tier boots. But I guess that's just what he wanted to do.
So like we said, Ice is once again fighting in the jungle. It looks like they get a pick on the Kha'Zix.
Yeah, good and numbers. there's a good place for...
Well, we got a collapse coming up. Twitch is coming from bottom. Got a poor ult from Might. Brian, there's so much you can do. Alamander sneaking up with the invisibility.
Yeah, it looks like he's probably gonna get Cassiopeia. Yeah, Cassiopeia is a very, very difficult champion to play, actually, and that ult is very hard to hit on target.
All right, Pixelbob diving up top lane.
Yeah, he's going hard, and he's gonna get it easy actually with that subjugate. He basically comes out with more health than he started with, and he's gonna get that tower. It's a 10k lead. Now, this is 6 to 20 kills. This is essentially insurmountable.
Oh, what a wall.
I don't think we're gonna get that third game this game.
Oh, definitely not.
Or this series.
I wouldn't be surprised to see a 20-minute surrender.
If all your... I doubt they will, just because it's a tournament, and people don't really do that, but I would have if I was in this game. This is what happens when all your lanes lose, and you have a jungle that's... made for ganking, and he doesn't really scale very well, and so they're just not picking themselves very... They're not winning lanes, and if you can't go win or go average in your lanes, you're gonna have a hard mid game, and that's what they've had here.
Yeah, it really went well for Top when not only did Trundle have... Oh my god, we got a fight over... Malamander might be shut down, but it goes to the Zac. I don't know if that's what I really want to see.
I mean, the shutdown goes to the whole team, so if you can kill him, you kill him. This is nice Kha'Zix jumping there.
Oh, Mega Average is going kind of brave. And the random Cassiopeia ult?
Yeah, I'm not sure what you wanted there. That was never going to be in
range.
Oh, we
got a flanking Anivia. Oh my, she just...
But Trundle's
so
still pushing top, and he's got the tower. So that's two towers on his push right now. And
Trundle's
the
just
going to
push top until somebody...
Yeah, he'll just push top until someone stops him. And there really isn't anyone on the team who can stop him. So
you can't just send one person. So the minute you send two people, then they just push down mid and they engage because they have numbers.
Yeah.
It's dire straits.
Yeah, and at this point, you have to just go back into your VODs and... see what you can work on as a team.
Wow. That can't even pick up his own wolves in peace.
No, and that's a bad feeling.
Looking at the vision, there's very, very, very aggressive wards for red team.
Yeah. Well,
They're
I mean,
even
that's what
inside
you
their
do when
base.
you're 13K ahead at 19 minutes.
I gotta hate that feeling when it's like you can't even step outside your base to ward.
Yeah.
That's gotta be one of the worst feelings.
That is
Forget getting
rough.
your jungle. You can't even ward. So you're.
And like it's now 80 CS is the difference in top lane. And even though the game was essentially lost in the other lanes as well, top lane probably wouldn't have put in the matchup. It's just approaching the flame horizon for Trundle. And he hasn't died yet. So he's definitely pretty strong. It looks like they're heading towards the
I
Baron,
mean,
yeah.
I don't even know if he's been ganked. Has Zac gone top one time? Like, I don't think he has. I think Zac has
Yeah.
just been like, you know what, Daniel? You're Dyrus right now. We can't help you.
Yeah.
Hope you survive. Hope you get strong. Maybe he'll leave.
Yeah. But
Then you can farm up.
he hasn't even completed an item yet. And that's a good, actually a very good Cassiopeia ult, but they're just
But not a good.
so far behind
Oh,
they
not a
don't
good
manage to
ulti.
get anything.
He spent so much time just like trying to ult the clone, and he just got picked apart by the Twitch with the rat-a-tat-tat.
Yeah, soon to be changed back to Spray and Pray, but for now, stuck with the old name. Yeah,
All right,
and
so
Anivia just does so much damage when she's ahead. She's just kind of oppressive.
it's retarded. 12,
And
1, and 9, almost fully stacked Rod of Ages, Archangels, and a Haunting, guys. So she's got double penetration on top of loads of mana and loads of magic pin.
yeah.
Or double pin mana and AP.
The only lane that should have gone about even was the Nami Ezreal lane, but I think it was just such a bad level one. That double kill that happened at like 3 minutes, it just translated into, I mean, it's probably the mental state too, because if you give up 2 kills that early after losing a 27-minute game just a few minutes before, that's got to weigh on your mind.
Oh, and Crimson Rage still doesn't go down.
No.
It's just really bad.
Ezreal ult, not so great unless you're AP.
I learned that the hard way today.
Yeah. I mean, AP Ezreal is fun, just like no wave clue, so.
Really hard that it's gotta suck for Cassiopeia because she can't buy boots. That means she's gonna have a hard time buying Tenacity, so when Trundle puts up the pillar, she just can't do
Yeah.
anything. That was unfortunate.
Yeah, and Anivia is just so huge right now, and she's actually building a Liandra's Torment just for extra annoyingness.
She's not
No,
even
she's
finishing the
bought.
Landry. She
No,
bought
she's
a
not. She's. It looks like
she went ahead
Alolan.
and bought another Needlessly Large Rod.
Even though I'm not sure what she's building that into, I guess maybe they're thinking the game will be over before he would build finish the all Liandry's. So they're
Got
just gonna go for this Infernal, then they're probably gonna go for the final push because they're sitting on the Baron buff still, so.
Wish there was a way to show what dragons they have in this interface. Oh, so we got a potential pick. All right, we got a pick on the Kha'Zix. This seemed to
Yeah, it's
be
a
the
very
way that
good
they.
Cassiopeia ult into the Zac BM jump run, but it's only gonna slightly delay them if it delays them at all. Because Kha'Zix really hasn't been the big thing in this game. It's been Alamander and it's been Ninth Ambition, really putting out the damage, and then Pixelbob doing his job and better than his job in top. He's just been a force, a split pushing force, and he's solo killed his opponent. He's doing everything
Make the
right.
top lane is such a non-factor.
Yeah.
It's really hard for Cat to defend that lane. Cassiopeia and Nami versus Baron minions, considering they don't take any kind of
Yeah,
magic damage.
his Cassiopeia is not the best at wave clear. Her wave clear is good, but it's slow. So I guess that means it isn't good. And then you've got Ezreal instead of like a Sivir.
Oh, so we
You
got the
really
flank
don't
by
have
Anivia.
good wave clear. Yeah, she's just so far ahead. She can do whatever she wants. She's 3 levels up on any. She's 1 level up on the Weave King and 3 levels up on Might.
Oh,
And
and hi
just two
oh, we got a
inhibs
nice little
down,
fight
yeah.
here. All right, so that Runon's Hurricane just doing so much work for the Twitch. Will Ezreal
Yeah.
fall? Looks like he will actually. The
Yeah,
poison picks,
Twitch
man.
is one of the best team fighting ADCs. And when he gets ahead, like he's
really gotten ahead in this game.
And I think this really should be it. Because they've got super minions crashing into the base. They've got a Trundle. They've got a Twitch.
With the point I made earlier, I like this team wants choke points. They want to get you in a straight line.
They do.
And then they want to fight you that way. So probably where this went wrong was in the very beginning by just walking into their jungle, because that's essentially what this entire team comp wants you to do. Hence why they invaded into your own jungle.
Yep. And the Janna Twitch is just such a good combo, because you buff up the Twitch, you keep him safe with your disengage, and he'll just kill everyone from the back line.
Just buff him and let him press R and then watch the whole team bleed. Well, GG. Two washed up. Good try by Nice. I just really think that they need to clean up, mainly in the top lane. I wouldn't even say the whole team got outdrafted, but the picks in top lane weren't very good, which is why I wish I could have seen how pick ban went down, because it seems like Alawi would have been a really bad champ Trundle as the same. Actually, I wouldn't even say that the last game, because I would probably trust Jason to the fork. But top lane just seemed to be the focus. That's where, I don't want to say it fell apart, but the lead was just so crushing that the gold lead ended up being insurmountable. Like,
it did.
Kha'Zix didn't go top one time.
But yeah, he didn't need to, yeah.
But Trundle didn't die.
And it
sacrificed everything, that I'm just gonna kill top lane. I'm gonna be a big, huge monster, and gonna be too much for the entire other team to handle.
Yeah. Alright, well, that's gonna be it for us tonight. I hope you enjoyed the pretty short games, and yeah.
Signing off, we've got Savage X 2 and Carnation.
Hey guys, thanks so much for coming out and tuning into this very nice little recast. I want to personally thank SavageX2 and Carnation, as well as Homicidal, for helping out tonight. They did some amazing work making sure we had some last minute tips, stats, and otherwise lower VA stats and everything like that. I'm DePurple Sharpie and I was streaming this cast. If you did like what you see, make sure that you come and check out the rest of the Lower VA Try Hard Tourney. The challenge is right there inside of the link. If you type in !! into chat, Nightbot will be so grateful to link that over to you. But if you're not able to, you can go over to challenge.com/LowerVA5S. That's once again challenge.com/LowerVA5S. If you'd like to join Lower VA for whatever reason, you can definitely find us on facebook.com/group/LORVAL. Once again, that's LORVAL. I'm DePurple Sharpie, and this has been Lower VA's Try Hard Tourney. Thank you so much for joining. Good night.